I started working at Mad Magazine in my late adolescence, and I was still a virgin, and I was still living with my parents, and had no place to take a girl, just in case something would happen. I mean, you know, in those days, boys would carry around a condom in their wallet until you could see the circular outline on the wallet after, and it would be crackling from disuse. But you wanted to be responsible, and you know, you didn't want to get somebody pregnant. It said they were stamped on each condom was the legend, sold in drugstores only for the prevention of disease. You know, that again, as though pregnancy were a disease. Now, of course, they don't print that on condoms anymore, and it is used for the prevention of disease. So, anyway, so I took my date to the Mad office. Bill Gaines, the publisher, had given me his key to the office, and there was a convertible sofa in the office there, and so it was evening, and there was nobody there. But we ended up, you know, for compulsive spontaneity, and so we didn't even get to opening the sofa, and just started groping each other, rolling around on the carpet with all of these mad paintings around from EC Comics. There was the Crypt Keeper, all these framed images. There was the Old Witch, and there right above us was this framed portrait of Alfred E. Newman. watching over us as we lost our physical virginity, just as he had watched over a generation who had lost their cultural virginity. And so as I could feel the voluntary motion about to change into involuntary motions, I slowed down and said, I better put something on for protection. And she said, oh, that's okay. You can fuck me without worrying. And I had never, in those days, girls didn't say language like that. I was shocked. I mean, even though we were in the middle of fucking, I was shocked that she said it. Oh, it's okay. You can fuck me without worrying. She said that, and the words just kept reverberating in my mind in a voice not quite my own, saying, what, me worry?